Hello, everybody. Hope you're having a great day. If you know it, say it with me. I have got my coffee. I got my Bible. Of course, I have all of you. Today is National Ninja Day. That's all I got to say on that. Come on, man. Who doesn't need a good Chuck Norris joke in their life? I mean, how about this one? Chuck Norris does not do push-ups. He pushes the earth down. Superman wears Chuck Norris pajamas. Every night, the boogeyman checks his closet for Chuck Norris. I mean, come on, man. Chuck Norris counted to infinity twice. I mean, do you know why they can't find signs of intelligent life anywhere on Mars? It's because Chuck Norris went there on vacation and he killed everything, right? I mean, Ninja Day, Chuck Norris Day, come on, it's all good. I love it so much. I want to know in the comments below, please give me your favorite Chuck Norris joke. Those are my favorites. I'm looking for, if you can find it, put the link in the description or the comments. I am looking for, and this is going to go to the Instagrams, the Facebooks, the Twitters, everywhere. I'm looking for one of those one-a-day calendars that has a Chuck Norris joke for every day. If you find it, you let me know. I will walk from here to wherever it is if I've got to. Those are my favorites. All right. Welcome to Matthew chapter number 20. All right. We're going through God's word every day, trying to bring out some hope for everyday life. There's an amazing story that I want to tell you about. Jesus, at this point, he is very well known. If you want to get well known, do a miracle, all right? Jesus is doing all the miracles, like he's doing all of them. And there's this moment when there are these two blind guys, and they're wanting to be seen. They want to see. They're trying to get Jesus' attention, but Jesus is way over there. And so they start screaming, Jesus, have mercy on us, because that's the only way they get their attention, right? Well, the Bible says in Matthew chapter 20, verse 31 through 34, that people around them started saying, be quiet, the crowd yelled at them. But they shouted even louder, Lord, Son of David, have mercy on us. And when Jesus heard them, he stopped and called, what do you want me to do for you? Lord, they said, we want to see. And Jesus felt sorry for them. He touched their eyes, and instantly they could see. Then they followed him. Now, I don't know exactly how this happened. I always use my imagination. I try to watch the Bible. And I wonder if Jesus is way over here. He's healing people. He's talking to people. And they're yelling. And he gets into earshot. At this point, they're like, come on. He's not going to hear you. But they're not going to give up. They're not going to give up. They're not going to give up. And finally, he hears them. And I don't think Jesus was being rude or mean to them. He's not looking at them going, what can I do for you? I wonder if he's on his way. And he's like, yes, I hear you. What can I do for you? As he's walking. I wonder. I don't know. And they're saying, Jesus, we want to see. And then I wonder if it's about that time Jesus gets there and he sees them. And the Bible says he felt sorry for them. They had mercy on them and he healed them. Do you know what got Jesus' attention? Their desperation. What if they said, Jesus, I need you to heal me. And then he was out of earshot. He didn't hear them. They wouldn't have got healed. I wonder how many people during the lifetime of Jesus on this earth didn't get healed because they yelled out one time and he didn't respond in that moment, and so they gave up. Or how about this? They yelled and the crowd around them made them feel intimidated, and so they quit. But these two guys, they yelled for Jesus. When they didn't hear Jesus at first, they yelled even louder. When the crowd around them said, man, it's hopeless. You need to give up. You're embarrassing yourself. They yelled even louder. Until finally they got Jesus' attention. And then they said, we want what we know you can do. We need our healing. And then when he healed them, they followed him. Can I tell you something? Maybe you can identify with their story. Maybe you're in a place and there's all this chaos around you and you don't know what's going on. Remember, they were blind. They don't know. They hear, but they can't see. All this chaos is around them. And you're needing Jesus to do something special for you. And so maybe you've yelled out in your prayer time, Jesus, I need your help. But he didn't answer that first time. Or maybe you've tried to take a stand in your faith and people are criticizing you everywhere. Don't let the voices of the crowd stop you from pursuing Jesus. Don't let shouting into what feels like the dark stop you from pursuing Jesus. Keep pursuing Jesus, because if you will keep pursuing Jesus, miracles will happen. I'm gonna make you a promise. This is a bold promise. You keep going after God and God will move in your life. I guarantee it. Now, I don't know what he's gonna do. I don't know how he's gonna do it. What I do know is he's faithful. And don't listen to the crowd. Don't listen to anyone else that tells you to stop. You go after Jesus and he will always answer in some kind of way. And I hope that brings you some hope. Stay desperate. As the one guy says, stay hungry, my friends. Hope that brings you some hope. I love you so much. You're probably doing better than you realize in your life right now. You know why? Because you got up one more day. God has not changed his mind about you. Such an honor to be your pastor. Hope you have a great day. I'll see you here tomorrow for Daily Hope.